morning, everyone. We called up Logan and Elliot and his little brother last night and asked them favorite colors and stuff. Elliot said rainbow black. Okay, rainbow black coming up. This is going to be cool. I'm just making it up as I go. But this is something new I kind of been trying, and it works so well that I think I'm just going to have it be my thing. Is these. If you get it down like that, get all your folds up like that, you can pull on it, and it doesn't collapse everything so bad. And if you want, you can make it real tight. I'm gonna make rainbow black. You're going, what? Sure, why not? This little boy's gonna be happy. Well, with these, you can kind of decide where you want your colors to go. What I'm gonna do. I might have got that first one a little too tight, but that's kind of what I wanted, I think. You know, who knows? Just kind of, it's art. That looks good. Keep pulling it, getting it all nice and straight. This is gonna be like the flag fold. But I'm just gonna make it up as I go and be different. Do it too tight, I think. And I just want a bunch of different separations so I can have different colors of the rainbow and black. There's gotta be some black in there, you know, because that's what he said. Yeah, it's actually very intelligent. He will appreciate this probably and be so delighted, I hope. It's so easy when you do it with the tie straps. You can kind of steer where everything goes and it stays where you want it. It makes this go fast. I'm gonna have a lot of different colors. I've got dark purple and light regular purple and, well, I've got a lot of different colors here to play with. It's gonna be a fun shirt here. Too bad it's gonna take till tomorrow to see. But that's part of this thing, is it helps develop patience, I think. It's something I could use a little more of. I'm a pretty impatient person. We all are, I think. It's the gratification sort of a thing. Boy, this is going to have a lot of different colors in graduations. I'll break it up with black every once in a while, I think. Because that's what he wants. He don't know what he wants yet. But I think he's going to love this. Well, I'm going through some tie straps. Things to do. I try to whip this shirt out real quick. Now we gotta decide what the bottom will be. Very bottom. How about just black on the edge at the bottom? Well, there's a lot of room for different colors. We gotta make a plan here. See what we got. Yellow for sure somewhere. And
That was Roy G. Biv. We're not quite ready yet. But I'm lining up colors. Red. Orange. There's some more different orange. There's blue. Purple. This is a dark purple. And I've got a very little black. I think I'm just going to add a little water to this to stretch it a little. I could mix up more, but I remember when I mixed this, I made it extra black. There's bound to be plenty in there. Enough for what I'm doing here. Maybe I'll just a little more. For sure I have enough for this little tiny shirt. Okay. Now we need to get our tray. Well, I'm not quite done folding. I'm getting a little hurried here. Let's see. Another black. Let me get these tools out of here. I was working on the honey tank. Clean it up. Okay. Let's get this Roy G. Biv thing going. Red, orange, yellow. Okay, that's a lot of different colors, and then break it up with black. That works well. And then what about the top? I don't know, but I just think LA would look good in blue. Let's just kind of scrunch this up. Just like one of them, it's just like doing the flag shirt, except I'm going to do it a little different. Kind of showing the whole thing here. I'm folding it and everything, kind of. Some of these rubber bands are a lot looser than others because they've been used several times. Those are the ones I'm trying to find and use. I think I want one more tie right here. The shirts that I've done successfully using this type of method work the best if they have a tie right here to keep the top of the shirt separate. It still kind of bleeds a little, which is something you really can't avoid with tie-dye. That's kind of what you want, in a way. It makes it random art. Some people are a lot better at keeping it in place where they want it to be. I'm not there yet. Okay. I do want to rubber band this here to keep it from getting dye from here on the rest of everything. If it fans out or something, it could mess it up. Okay, let's get the rest of the stuff I need here. Sorry I left for so long. I had to find the snips. These, I'm going to use 10 snips. Sticking them out of my way. This is quick tie-dye. It might turn into several videos. My camera is doing weird things. See, I'm taking the video card out of the GoPro and sticking it in my phone and then using a video editing app, and for some reason that app splits it into pieces. So So you'll get part one, two, and three, or something. I don't know. I don't know until it does it. It's kind of random, just like everything I do. Okay. Let's glove up and do this shirt. Top we want. Ooh, I forgot about this color. That's a nice color too. Where does it go though? Fuchsia. I think we'll just put it out in the top and then not anywhere else. Cause it's kind of a round color. But it will go with blue. I've done it before. So let's do blue and purple for up in the top on fuchsia. Wet rag. Kind of want to remember that. Never damp rag. Make sure it don't have bleach on it. I think I want a dry one too. Okay, I'm all set, finally. Sorry it took me so long. I'm not a pro.